Sue's bright idea.
It's my bright idea.
She loves singing, and we both like singing together, and we thought it might be an idea to make it worthwhile for a cause. And my mother is actually suffering with dementia right now, so we thought we'd do an old time sing along, and we're supported by the Alzheimer's Society, and a percentage of the profits today go to the Alzheimer's Society. And we thought, well, you know, we wanted to get on with it. It is a sing-along, so it's not just about listening to Sue or I sing. It's about everybody joining
enjoying
in.
Themselves.
And it's also about stimulation for older people, getting them out of the house and coming along and having a team biscuits in half, complimentary, of course, in half time, and singing some of the old songs, and some actually slightly newer songs, too, that are into the 60s. So it's got as a very, very show.
Of course, see, one of the things with Alzheimer's is short-term memory is quite bad, but long-term memory, people tend to remember the old songs.
Yeah.
That's why we're singing all the old songs, so that everyone can join in. And it's about having a really lovely afternoon, a bit of a party, really. Are you going to sing with us?
Well, of course, I'll sing along now. I appreciate the Al Jolson reference you did there as well.
Yeah.
This is the first one. I understand you've sold out.
Yes.
So does that mean, hey, let's do this again?
Well, we've already actually got about another four bookings. So I think it's going to be an ongoing thing. So
you know, you can't do these things without the public. So as long as they're supporting it, and they have really supported it, and some of the care homes as well are bringing some people along today as well, which is terrific. You know, then we'll do it. You know, if it's out there and they want it, well, we've offered it. It seems to be successful. Let's hope we do more of it.
Well, fantastic. And obviously, your name still brings many, many people to come and see you. I want to ask you a question that, going back to the dollar days, I asked Eric Faulkner of Bay City Rollers only last week.
Yes.
See what your response is. If you launched today and you were the age you were then, how do you think you'd have fared in today's market?
Well, musically, we would have been... so I'll answer that question in a... I think if I was to launch Dollar today, it would be totally different. I guess we'd have to approach it totally differently. Although melodies don't change too much, lyrics change, lingos change from, like, you know, doll to chick to whatever that they're saying these days. And, of course, production techniques really have changed over 20 or 30 years. So... The basic message of love, sex, rock and roll is still there, I guess. But it's just, you know, the newfangled gadgets that can produce the sounds that sell today.
And, I mean, your career had a roller coaster. You recently came back in prominence with I'm a Celebrity Again. Did you really enjoy the jungle experience?
Did I enjoy the celebrity experience? I did, actually. For probably all the wrong reasons. I mean, for all winding some of those people up in the jungle that really took themselves far too seriously as celebrities. I think we're very lucky to do what we're doing, and to sort of get a bit big-headed about it, or, you know, a bit snooty about it, I think is wrong. So I like to go and ruffle a few feathers.
Finally, you've had some political interest when you were in Brighton. Is that still something that you're interested in, or what were you likely to do in the future?
I stood as a candidate in Brighton for the Conservatives, actually, as a councillor in 2007 May elections. And recently I was incensed, of course, like most people were, by the expenses that the MPs had been claiming. And I thought, ooh, you know what, I might put myself back in the ring. Go as the no-expense party. Vote for me, no expenses whatsoever.
Right, okay.
Of course, Anna Duncan's fell foul of it today and has had to resign because he doesn't think he's getting paid enough and treated well enough. Unfortunately, it is not an old gentleman's club, the House of Commons. It's paid for by the taxpayer and it's funded by them. Would I go back into it? I don't know. I'm very busy with all my theatrical work at the moment. But you never know. Never say never.
OK, apart from the forthcoming today and forthcoming concert, what else have you got in mind?
I've just signed my deal for my book. I have a show called Brides on the Bus, which will come out next year, which I film in a couple of weeks' time. Brides on the Bus, 10 brides going from Land's End to Gretna Green, and as they go through the stages, they get left at a bus stop. Final girl wins the wedding, gets their wedding paid for. And of course, so would you dump me now?
Yeah, I've got a show on the same channel, so...
Called?
We're both going to... It's called So Would You Dump Me Now?
Okay.
It's about women that have been dumped, and we give them a makeover. and then they go back and confront their ex. So, yeah, David and I will be on TV at the same time in January next year.
Okay, so it's a ratings war between the two of you then.
Absolutely.
Okay.
A competition.
All right, well, of course you'll give
It might be difficult for me because she works for the Southern newspaper as well. She's the beauty editor, so I think she's got a few friends there.
And of course you'll give us your tack, the first bite of the cherries, as we say.
Of course.
Thank you very much indeed.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
So, I won't leave it any longer. I'm going to welcome to the stage David Van Day.
The good old bad old day.
Well, that's a good start.